Hello everyone, thanks for watching this video. Hope you all are doing good today. Today in this video, I am going to discuss and demonstrate about web protection capability in Microsoft Defender for Endpoint. Before proceeding further, let's discuss why do we need a functionality like web protection? When we already have gateway firewalls, web proxies, and antivirus solutions to secure our devices. Solutions like gateways, firewalls, and web proxies holds good when the device is in a perimeter network. But during this pandemic time, users are looking for a flexibility to work from anywhere instead of just from office. As users are outside the perimeter network, it would be a challenge for organizations to secure the data which is present on the devices. So the capabilities like web protection in Microsoft Defender for Endpoint can help organizations to regulate the unwanted content and secure devices against web threats over the internet even when the user is outside the perimeter network. Web protection can help in stopping access to phishing websites, malware websites, exploit sites, untrusted and low reputation sites, as well as the sites that are blocked by the administrator. Web protection is not just a single product, but it's a combination of multiple components of Microsoft Defender for Endpoint. Let's discuss them one by one. The first component of web protection is web threat protection. By integrating with various browsers like Microsoft Edge, Google Chrome, or Firefox, web threat protection can help organizations to protect devices from the various web threats, irrespective of where the devices are. The devices can be inside the perimeter network, devices can be outside the perimeter network, but they are protected from the web threats. The second component of web protection is web content filtering. Leveraging web content filtering, organizations can track and regulate the access to the website based on the content categories like criminal activity, social networking, emails, external emails, and many more. Many of these sites might not be malicious, but might be problematic to the organizations because of the compliance regulations, bandwidth usage, or other concerns. The final component of web protection is custom indicators. Indicators of compromise, that is IOCs, is an essential feature of every endpoint protection solution. Leveraging custom indicators, the organization security operations team can define the custom indicators for detection and for blocking. They can define custom indicator either based on file hash, IP addresses, URL or domains, and even on certificates.
Now we know that web protection is made up of multiple components, that is web threat, web content filtering, and custom indicators. And each of these components is enforced by the Smart Screen client in Microsoft Edge and by network protection client in other browsers and applications. So let's see what will be the order of precedence if there is any conflict in these components. So if in case of any conflict, custom indicators will be always having the higher precedence than web threats and the web content filtering components.
The next question that might come to your mind is how web protection is protecting devices against these web threats. Even if the user is using either Microsoft browser or any other third-party browser or application. If a user is using one of the Microsoft browser, then a smart screen client that is built into the browser will send the request to the smart screen cloud services. And the smart screen cloud services would check whether the site is potentially malicious and decide if the URL need to be blocked or allowed. If in case if the user is using any third-party browsers like Google Chrome or Firefox, then it would be the responsibility of the network protection client to send the request to the cloud services. And the Smart Screen Cloud Service would check whether the site is a potentially malicious and decide if the site need to be blocked or it need to be allowed.
Before starting the demo, let's see what all restrictions is being configured in Microsoft Defender for Endpoint. In custom indicator, what I have configured Amazon.in and Facebook.com as the sites which users should not be able to access, as well as users should not be able to communicate to a specific IP address. And under web content filtering, what I have done, I have configured that social networking sites and web-based emails as well as instant messaging sites should be blocked. So let's go ahead and see whether all these configurations are restrictions are really in place on the devices and how it is impacting the users. This is my Windows 10 test machine, and let's see whether I'm able to access those restricted sites on this machine or not. Let me try with Microsoft Edge first. Let's see whether we are able to open facebook.com. You can see that we are not able to access facebook.com, and let me try with amazon.in as well. Yes, even I'm not able to access amazon.in. And the another setting what I have done is I have configured social networking sites, web-based email, as well as the instant messaging sites. So let me try whether I'm able to access Twitter. I should not be able to access it. Yes, I'm not able to access it. And let me try it at the gmail.com. This could also be blocked. And let me try with one example of instant messaging, that is web.whatsapp.com. And you can see we are not able to access this whatsapp.com. Let me try one more thing, and let's see whether the same restrictions are applied on the user once he is trying to access these websites using Google Chrome. We can see that user is not able to access twitter.com, and now let's try to access the instant messaging one. And yes, web.whatsapp.com is also not working, and let me try with Gmail now. Let's see whether that is working or not. Not able to access it. And the other restriction, one more restriction I have configured is specific to the IP address. Let me try that one as well. Before trying on this particular test VM, let's try to access that on my another system. So this is the server IP address, and let me try to connect it. So I am able to connect, and I'm able to take the remote desktop session for this server. Let me log out, and let's validate if I'm able to access it on that VM as well. You can see I'm not able to access the server, the same server using the RDP client. And now you can see that all the settings what we have done is really in place on the client. And whatever configuration we have done is working perfectly fine. Let's have a look what all we have covered in this video. And we covered why do we need web protection, and then we discussed about the different components of web protection. And what will be the order of precedence if there is any conflict in the different components of web protection. And then we have seen that how the web protection is actually protecting the devices, either using the smart screen client or the network protection client. And at the end in the demo, what we have seen, we have seen how all those restrictions have impacted the end user clients. I hope this will be informative for you. Please do share and subscribe if you really like the video. If in case you want me to make video on specific topic, please do mention in the comment section of this video. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.